Hey campers, Mark here from Overland Trailer, and this week we're going to do some math.
You're listening to the Simple Camping Podcast. This is where we'll explore the joys, sorrows, and adventures of camping in the great outdoors through editorials, interviews, and of course, stories.
All right, campers, I know in the last episode about steel and aluminum, I told you that this episode I would tell you about how the steel and aluminum stuff that the government's been doing has been affecting our business. And I will be doing that. However, I want to get another guest on the podcast, somebody else in the steel industry. And at the same time, I'm camping right now in a teardrop trailer, as you can see if you're watching the YouTube. And while we're here, I just had this epiphany, and I was like, I need to talk about this. So, basically, that's what today is going to be about, and it's going to be focused really on let's do the math, which is a great part of keeping it simple. Simple camping allows us to go outside and see what we want to see without having to mess around with a lot of stuff. I'm actually at a campground. It's rare that I have an opportunity to camp in a teardrop trailer, even though that's our company, and so forth, but because our rentals are out all the time during the summer, and I don't own one myself anymore because I could just use one from the business. So it was nice of my parents who own one to loan me theirs. So I got in and I just shot out to a campground just overnight. And when I pulled in, there were some people who pulled in right next to me in a Toyota Tacoma, and if you're watching the YouTube, I'll show you a little picture of their camp. It was just a husband, wife, and they had a tent to set up, and when we pulled in, I said this would be a great experiment, because I've always wondered how long setup is in a teardrop versus a tent. And, you know, I said, you know, this is an RV, it's got to be more complicated and all of that. So I pulled out my phone, and I turned on my stopwatch, and I pressed go. And at that moment was the moment they were opening up the back of their truck, and I got out of the Jeep and started to level and set up the teardrop. I'm going to tell you the results of that toward the end, our little race that they didn't know was a race. I did tell them about it a little bit later, but keeping it simple, when we're looking at time and we're camping, there are several things that we can do to save time, but at the same time, especially in our industry where we're looking at a small trailer, we're using every single square inch for something. We also want things that have multiple uses. And there's a lot of camping gear that's just like it has only one function. And some of it's really cool. Like, I think Coleman has a propane-powered, like, coffee maker, drip coffee thing. And it's really cool. Because you get the same kind of coffee that you would get at home out of a drip coffee system, but it's powered by propane, but it has only one function, and it's something like 17 inches tall. And if you have the space, that's great, but for me, I'm like, I'm storing this thing in my vehicle or in my camper. It's going to take up a lot of space, and it only does one thing. So I like to look at things that have multiple uses, which I'll get to in a second, but there's some things that I really, you know, the internet is filled with camping hacks, and some of them are really cool, and some of them are just ridiculous. Ratchet straps for me are like one of the most useful things when camping, outside of backpacking, because they can weigh a fair amount, but any other type of camping, ratchet straps are the best, and they help me save time. And I use them in multiple ways. So the math of that is I have one ratchet strap, I can do 15 different things. So the return on your investment, so to speak, for that thing is quite high. I've used them just between two trees as a clothesline. You know, you're down at the beach, you get back, the family throws their towels and their swimming suits and all that sort of thing. Or you do your dishes, you throw them in a mesh bag and hang them from that and let them dry. You can throw a blanket up there. It's just so many uses for just that one line. And you can, with a ratchet strap, you can make it nice and tight. You can also secure your loads with it. You can, this is another one that I really like to do with a hammock, is stick a ratchet strap on it. So you can get it at exact right height and tautness that you want for your hammock. So I was going to go camping, and I was just going to be by myself, and so I stopped at a rest stop on the way, and there was a guy there who had taken one of those, like, one of those utility trailers that you buy at one of those big box hardware stores. So I started asking him a few questions, because I was also looking at his trailer. He had taken this utility trailer and started converting it into some sort of off-roading camp vehicle, and so he had apparently been out on the trail, and his axle came off the mount, and the pin that held the spring for his axle broke or something. And so what he did with a ratchet strap was he stuck a piece of wood in there to keep it from just rattling around making crazy noise. And they took like three ratchet straps and just ratcheted his axle onto his trailer. It was out of alignment and all sorts of things. But again, the ratchet strap, it has so many different functions. This next one, the tarp, I thought I might just do an entire episode on the tarp, an entire podcast, but in brief, the tarp is really useful, of course, for keeping rain off, which is usually what we think of, but it's also very useful for collecting water if you need water, and it's a good thermal barrier, so if it's cold outside, you could even just wear it as a coat and it helps keep you warm. So I think that's why you see a lot of tarps and probably a lot of ratchet straps, but they do have so many different uses. And the thing that I like about them is the math on them makes sense. Like, I pack this one thing and I can do 15 things with it. Granted, there are some things you need to take that have one function, but I am of the opinion that I need to minimize those things. So this is what my wife and I do. When we go camping, we'll stock our teardrop trailer with our stuff or what we think we need. And we put little round stickers on everything. Whenever we use that item, we pull the sticker off. And then we'll camp like 3 or 4 or 5 times. And then we go through the trailer, and anything that still has a sticker on it gets taken out of the trailer. We don't need that. And then as we go camping more and more and more, there may be something that we realize, like, we just haven't used this in a long time. Maybe that was just a one-off thing, that we just didn't use it very often. So that's one way to keep it simple and to save yourself some time and to make things more efficient. Back to my camping race experiment. Now, I kept myself setting up the teardrop trailer at a regular pace. Like, I just went methodically and I just figured, like, we'll see how long it takes them and how long it takes me. But basically what happened was I pulled in, I leveled the trailer, which took me a couple of minutes, maybe 2 or 3 minutes. And then I opened up the door, and I had packed in a rush. So I had taken, like, everything that I was going to take on this trip and just threw it in here. Literally just a pile. And so I went through my pile of stuff, got my clothes arranged. Then I went back, and I opened up the galley, and I got the galley arranged because I'd thrown some groceries in there, got that all set up. Because these people are going to have to do the same thing on their picnic table. And then I was cooking hot dogs when I heard the blower for their air mattress turn on, and they actually spent about an hour and 20 minutes setting up their camp, and for me it was about 15 to 20, somewhere in there. So the return on investment for the trailer for me, I was like, man, I just saved myself 45 minutes just by the way I am camping. Not that one form is better than another, it's just, I was instantly enjoying my experience, and they were still messing with their mattress and getting the blankets out and all of that sort of thing. Hypothetical situation, but pretty realistic. Let's take a hypothetical journey, right? For 30 days, we're going to do a road trip. You're going to take the family, you're going to pile the kids and the dogs or whatever, and you're going to get in the car, and you're going to go tent camping for 30 days. Days and maybe see the sights, you know, go see all those national landmarks, go visit the relatives that are across the nation somewhere else, or, you know, maybe travel to another country. Whatever it is, you're going to go for 30 days on the road and you're going to tent camp. So here's the math on this. I'm going to cut their setup time down to an hour because I really think they could have been more efficient. There were a few trips to the bathroom and stuff, so I'm just going to cut it down straight to an hour. So you start your journey and you set up the first night, takes an hour. The next day you get up and it takes probably about an hour to pack everything up, and then you drive. And then you get to your new destination, it takes an hour to set up. over the span of 30 days, you're going to spend 58 hours setting up and tearing down camp, which when you think about this, that's a month, and you're going to spend a full work week setting up and tearing down camp. That's not very efficient. It's not very simple. It's not, and for people who really enjoy the gear, that might be very enjoyable. For me, I'd rather be experiencing what's around me than just dealing with my tent again. That's just the math, simple math. Then you might say, well, there's always the upkeep of an RV. What does it take and all of that? And that's true. Like, you get one of those big RVs and you have water systems, you have electrical systems, the roof can leak, you have all these other things in it that get expensive and time, you know, becomes important at that point. But if you have a smaller trailer, like a little pop-up or a teardrop, maintenance on this is very minimal. We've had several of them come in. It takes, you know, 45 minutes every year to maintenance them. And to put them to bed for the off-season takes about 30 minutes. So it's not a big deal. Whereas tents, you spend, you know, the 58 hours on the journey, and then you get home, and you got to haul it all out of the car and pack it someplace. And if it was wet because you were camping someplace wet, you got to pull it all out, set it back up, and let it dry out, and then pack it. But at the end of a long trip, sometimes the last thing I want to do is set up my tents again and dry them out. Just my thoughts for the day. Doing the math, keeping it simple, use multi-use items. Try the sticker system. See if you use those things, then you don't have to haul it if you don't use it. And it just makes sense. If you want to see that Coleman coffee maker, I'll put some links down below. I hope you guys have a great week, and I will catch you in the next one.
This episode of the Simple Camping Podcast was brought to you by OverlandTrailer.com. Log on to OverlandTrailer.com to see all episodes of this podcast, as well as on iTunes, Google Play, and all the other places you like to find your podcast.